It
is the dispossession of the people for the benefit of the few.
That land does not belong to us them.
In modern cities, malls are constructed at the outskirts of the city.
This is now to your party, the Dama, on the side.
Number of people are walking away. Dislodging a foreigner. How many people is he going to employ?
This is the Mampong community.
The greatest land.
What are you going to do?
The moonlight sleeping on a midnight day, and we are homeless. Humbo. Moonlight sleeping on a midnight day.
Over 3,000 men and women head towards the place every morning in search of their daily bread. For about three decades, hundreds of thousands of cars visit the center for maintenance, and about 5,000 students receive their educational support from the village. One day, a nightmare hits this village. Bulldozers sweep sheds and workshops. Mighty containers lay flat. Occupants cannot hold down tears.
Many dead tonight could be.
Strong wind.
Many dead tonight could be you. And
we are the once populated village is nothing but a replica of a cemetery.
We are homeless.
This is the story of the relocation of the Tanokrom village artisans to Kansaradu Mampong. The story that has left many jobless for weeks. We find out the circumstances that surrounded the relocation, the litigations, the before, the during, and the after of the relocation. We will seek the opinion of stakeholders and finally visit the sites and the Mampong community itself, all from artisans to shopping mall. On 7th February 2014, a joint military and police team, acting upon a court order, raised down hundreds of shops at the Tanokrom Kokompe village. An estimated value of properties worth 50 million Ghana cedis was destroyed. Many could not hold down tears.
Hana mafa nyama me di free. Kafa me info jeans. Store shirt na de. Ma koji loan. Fana dim finance. Every day be am 280,000. Na se se away to way to money. Bet na info na me fa mu kunu yare. Ala ma mi nyobi ala ma kote bi etir. Bo ya tir mi e dia o fia na me chada na ka tie bi bia. Se se hana mi didi. Hana mi didi. Wono. Mo won won.
But what motivated those decisions that was going to take away the source of livelihood for thousands of fellow humans or countrymen in this manner?
Assembly has a primary function to demolish without notice we can always uproot without notice. But most importantly, there was a court order asking the SDME to ensure vacant possession of the land and hand over to the owners. And those were the two factors and authority that underpinned our action. It is my duty to ensure compliance with the law, and that's what I did.
The spokesperson for National Movement for Economic Democracy, Kweku Abuaje Buampo, disagrees.
Court order, I'm not it's a court order. I know my cutting. Also, my one can say, but one of court order so bad. War, baby, I'm a can't carry the waste because you're better for waste than this one. I've been in a court order, come back. It's my act in the corner. They send you the same threat of imprisonment. You're not going to have a teacher. As I see, I crack for Ghana National News Agency, GNA website. Watch your over there. STM. Wako ji asasi da mankofu no ni contract na for ji asasi we si se da mankofu no ho na amara we ti na asisi ai asasi ni wa we tu ni otu ni mu de obi an be ji asasi dia won ho even under manipulations from contractor me o se on be ji asasi won tu e kawo nti obi baba won tu mbacho mo yi da man sam na ri nya wo ho nti se eye city mayor e ko yi o ko ni mu o ko ni chi o je wa koko actually, if some of you can want to come with the president, none of them invent here, won't see a Duma, 1 year Duma, 1 year Duma, academic. The president has a policy. His vision is what Captain is here to implement. And the president needs to invent him 1 year Duma. One year woman, remember, they want to contribute to national development. And that's a captain. And you may come for a war, and you may come here, and maybe I knew you could sweep more. And you know, Uncle Fee, well, woman, money, what can you do? Next up, there or they relocate one. But we bought on your money shopping mall. It makes a shopping mall. Process is what they familiar. The rapidity with which you ordered that one can say one. I've been intimately used the same rapidity. I'm going to say the best one.
What level of engagement took place between the artisans and city authorities, particularly the mayor, Captain Anthony Kujio, retired?
There had been prior discussion with the garages. Long, almost a year, I had had discussions with them in my office several times. Mr. Shen, who I think is a local rep, and Mr. Nkrumah, who is a secretary, and some others have been in my office. Sometimes they come in the, about 10. The last time they came, they even came with a lady. And I was interested in the lady because I thought she was also a teacher. She said, no, I have a store there. I sell paints. So I have had and continue to have. The last meeting we had, I can't say the exact date, but the last meeting was a meeting which agreed that nominations to set up a land allocation committee should be set up. The garages were to bring nominate two persons, the SCMA 3 and other stakeholders. And my intention in this case was even to bring on board the Amnesty International, because Amnesty International also engaged us in a discussion relating to this same matter. So we have done a lot. They decided to withdraw from the discussion unilaterally.
At what point in the discussion?
At the point where they were to submit the names of the members of the allocation committee.
And Oman can't tell the reason why they decided to withdraw.
Incommunicado, my PRO called them several times to the point where I said, fine, I will draft a letter. And in a letter I sent to them, I said I was giving them up to Friday of that week that if they did not respond, we were going to act without them. And that took more than a month before I took that decision.
As an assembly, we are guided by rules, regulations, and regulations. We have an act that should guide whatever we do, and then we also have modest standards under statutory documents. And I've never come across any of them that should tell us that an individual in the assembly, like a chief executive, can use any authority or power there be. Should not take necessary decisions, because we have committees in assembly, and then things of this nature should have gone to either works committee or development planning subcommittee. They should have discussed things of this nature, and then of this magnitude, it should have come to the floor of the general assembly for a general decision to be taken. But I'm yet to know anything of that sort. And I think this SI should call for serious investigations by the assembly. And some of us, we are going to ensure that we investigate how come what has happened this morning happened. It's a serious thing. Because immediately you mention the assembly, all of us are involved. The assembly doesn't only go with Captain Kudu. He's the chief executive, but we have other honorable members. As he is an honorable member, so is all of us. Yes, he's the chief executive. That is the reason why he can't take in decisions unilaterally. He must seek the consent of the General Assembly, so that whatever comes out of any decision or action will not be associated with one person, because it is going to be the STMA, and all of us are involved. That is why the consent of membership is very, very paramount in some of these regards.
The artisans have been on this piece of land for more than 3 decades. But why this portion of land and not any other area?
This is my motherland, Lady Ghana, tiny.
In modern cities, malls are constructed at the outskirts of the city. And in our peculiar situation, when you talk about a mall, it is meant for a certain class of the society, middle class people, who drive their vehicles to places where they think they will be comfortable shopping and showing their class. Now, if you build a mall at the present day Tanokrom fitting shop, one, what we are doing is that you are going to create more congestion. Two, you are going to crowd out all the small petty traders within the center of city. Because the normal thinking of the Ghanaian is that, oh, I'm going to shop at the mall. The person goes there and maybe buys a ton of mall, but he went to the mall. So that will kill the small scale businesses and the congestion aspect. So I think, again, when cities are growing, you do not contract the development of the city, you expand it. So you send such new developments outside the city centers, where other social infrastructure, as a result of a single investment, will also be available and bring about a rippling effect of development. But if you concentrate every single economic development activity within the center, you create a situation that we have in Takoradi and Sengeni now. All vehicles lead to places where economic activities are, and the congestion itself becomes negative in the long run.
PC is speaking from the old archaic school of thought. We are in a modern society, and worldwide societies and communities are developing. Now, also more we also Tanokrom they shift one item. And I shift one map. He use land in free. The moon not small kind of space. You can find open spaces in your dear playground and all that. If he had seen the design, I think that his comment would have been different. I'll make one of the designs available, the design that we have available to him, so that he can see it and change his ideas. Now, the other interesting thing is that PC did not have the opportunities I have had as a soldier and as an employee of Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority. I have traveled worldwide on we are in here, baby, on my trip there. And me to come to malls, yes. Some malls are built in outskirts, taking into account certain social and economic, you know, factors into consideration. Some malls, most malls are in cities. When you go to London, New York City, Washington, other places in even the Far East, Middle East and so on. Malls are in the cities. And especially if you go to the new, very newly developed cities in the world, in Oman, in Abu Dhabi. In Abu Dhabi, there's a place called Sharjah. It's a huge mall city. So I am of that contemporary and modern school of thought that it is possible.
Some stakeholders and a good number of the artisans raised some concerns on facilities available at the new sites.
No, dear Brian, or dear Brian, but now, no, as I said, yes. Oh, man, yeah, yeah. I did be in Chirase, Ahanu, Nipan, or the Bahadi. In together, on your Botra Sana, or 2 years, Hanny, and Sana, or 2 or 3 years. Of course, no, dear Jane, since you are saying, or be Ajma, Ajman, so I say, no, or be as who are bound, or you didn't know, or Yajman, or did you? This year, what will be Ajma? This year, Hannah, as I said, Crampo, or no. I did be, I know about my, you know, about Nadi. We in suit about that group, and for Pia, no, but imagine. Among paying for now, because on two umbra number, on Mammy Regional Minister, Nanka, somebody as Asina, or Siamba Town, or Omutna Ocean, or the Magic Sabu, and Yamadia, and Omutna Ocean, or Manka, and two Omuna and Grandpa. So, Okada, you're paying Papa, no, it's not regional office, on two Omumbra, as Asina, or Siambra, or Omba, as Asina, Papa, or to Nipa, or Hotta, no, on Yadamia, or the Omutman, or no, I don't know if you're 4 years in Nigeria.
So far, the time Abasa, in a sense, they it took away to another world to artisans. Nothing in a entire year war or a eternal only a day. We see, maybe I'm an artisan. I'm a man, only my warrior. We two are triadro. We two are akoto ayamunichuma. The menti asena ayewo. Yehu. Anadi yenya. The menti aseno. Pepepe. Ocha sisi awunichuma. Yenya. Usande. Just about some time ago. Ende. Masana ako. Site honu. Ako hede. About 2 months. Meko ho manoti. Improvement bi abeka honu. Road Nakasa and Rocco. So, what can say? Nerco, we did what I say.